tried and tested is an interesting phrase you use. And obviously we've seen since the financial crash, which happened 10 years ago, a real questioning of these economic theories and actually how they work in the real world and who wins and who loses. And obviously I've just talked about the winners and losers in the situation. But I think, you know, the real issue here, which the Bank of England governor have said is health, is that the big factors in the inflation we're seeing right now are fossil fuel prices, the disrupted supply chains, as you mentioned, partly because of the effects of climate change on food. And they're also huge profits corporations are taking. Now, raising interest rates will do nothing to address them. And the governor himself has said, you know, this can't bring down fossil fuel prices. So what we have now, you know, if we look at the big picture, is broken economic policy making, where we're using assumptions, theories from the past, which may have been tried and tested, but they don't work. And they will continue not to work in the current context we live in of, as we've seen, you know, huge disruptions in energy, in climate change, fossil fuel prices. And these aren't going away. They're only going to, you know, potentially get more complex and more severe.
But they have worked elsewhere, haven't they? I mean, this kind of policy's worked in the States through the Fed. We're just an outlier because of Brexit, because of whatever else that's had an impact on food prices. I mean, when I say they're tried and tested, Britain is kind of very slow in making this work this time round, but it does work for others. Or am I wrong?
No, it's exactly the same issue. You know, we positive money works in the US. We also work in the EU, and we've been raising this issue around what we're calling fossilflation and climateflation. A lot of the inflation we're seeing is driven by fossil fuel prices, of climate change effects on supply chains, especially with food. Obviously, you know, what's going on the ground in terms of economics is different in different situations, because it's not just about what central banks are doing, it's about what fiscal policy is doing as well. We've seen the Inflation Reduction Act in the US, which has been really important. You know, we do need to see more from the Treasury.